Hey, what's up, guys? So every year in Tucson, we have an event called the Southwest Indian Art Fair, and it's held here at the University of Arizona. Just an event that has all of these Native artists throughout the state, as well as from other states like New Mexico. I've come here every year with my family. I actually have a family member that comes down. It's just a place where I really get a lot of my inspiration from to do my own work. I actually got a gift from one of the vendors. I was just talking with this woman who was a potter from New Mexico. I was just having conversation with her. After a while, she came back and found me, and she gave me one of her pottery pieces. I'm gonna go ahead and go around and see if I can get other people to talk in front of my camera.
Horace, Quannie from the village of Kikusmovi.
Hopi.
Hopi. I've been carving Kachina dolls, but very contemporary, for 36 years. I stylized from the old style and gave it more of the sculptor form. Still the same concept of imagery of Kachina dolls, but just a very contemporary form. Jeweler Charles Olama kind of made me move beyond the level of what I was doing in the carvings. So I took it to the new level of bronzes, and now we're trying to implement the imagery into glass.
The one thing that I find a lot of Native people struggling with today is the changes of the modern world, and how we try to preserve our culture and our stories through our artwork. But before, it was really using artwork in forms of the symbolism for spiritual purposes. And now we have to call it art in order to attract the younger generation to want to learn about it and to get interested in why we have these symbols and the stories behind the symbols.
And a lot of the stories and symbols come from their parents, because if it's not the parents teaching them, or their aunts or uncles, then there's no way they're going to learn. So it starts at the home. They don't start with us as an individual artist. Maybe it could, but we are only there to influence them in how to do it, you know, and the technique and how to develop your own
style.
The influence of what I'm doing, to being very modern but still having a traditional imagery, helps our younger generation grasp and say they want to do what I do. If you keep them from being afraid or intimidate them from developing into, whether it's a graphic artist or a computer artist or any type of artist, it's still all a fit from our religion, our culture, and our values of what we do, whether it's Hopi or Navajo or whatever tribe. The style is always developing. There'll always be a new artist that will take up your concept of your ideas and try to do what you're doing, but it'll take years and years for them to do what you're already doing.
All right, well, cool, cool.
Lyston. My name is Eunice Lyston, and I am the Hana Atham. I'm a part of the Nordic Traditional Singers and Basket Dancers. It's a group that's been formed by my grandmother, Christine Johnson, about 20 years ago. And she felt it was very important to preserve our traditional songs, traditional dances. Very well-known basket weaver. She wanted to incorporate that and to honor basket weavers around the world. And so she formed this dance group, which started out very small, but as the generations have come in our family, more and more have joined the group, and we all come together. We sing about our we sing these traditional songs. The songs are mainly about different things in creation, whether it's about a mountain, whether it's about the birds that are doing the things that they do during the seasons, different animals, and the things that they do, the things that they teach us. Our family is part of our traditional upbringing, and which we feel is very important to carry on, because it really is a part of our lives, a part of who we are. It gives us strength, it gives us direction, gives us guidance in our lives, where our roots are.
How do you feel about traditionally these dances, would be held within the villages, but now, in this modern time, we have to have these gatherings of different various native peoples, and it's really more like of a cultural exchange. Some would call it kind of like a commercialization of our culture, but at the same time for us, it's a way of, I guess, showing pride of where we're from, showing that we're still here, I guess, is really a big part of it. So how do you feel about the contrast between the traditional aspect of the dance being held in the villages for ceremonial purposes versus it being like a performance here, staged?
Well, for us, from the very beginning, we would always make sure that whenever we go someplace, we share with them that it and share with our group that it's not a performance. I don't like that word performance, coming and just being on display.
Putting a show, yeah.
Right, because there's a lot of meaning behind the songs. There's a lot of meaning in the dances and the motions. It all has meaning. I don't like the word performance because it cheapens that. Whenever we go someplace, we always say, we'd like to share with you the things that are about our culture.
Thank you. And she is actually, we've been friends.
Yes.
So thank you so much.
You're welcome. So happy to share with you. It's glad to see you again. Oh, 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 oh